Hi guys, welcome to day four of the holiday card series for 2013. I'm starting out with this stamp set called Winter's Day from Saturated Canary, and I've mounted it on my compact stamp press using just a little strip of adhesive. These stamps don't have foam on the back, so you kind of have to mount them yourself or put it on easy mount. I'm stamping this particular image in archival jet black ink on some Simas to Stamp watercolor paper, and I'm using that ink in particular because I'm going to be doing some watercoloring with distress markers, and this is a waterproof ink that's going to be great for it. It's not going to smear or smudge while I watercolor. Like I said before, I'm using distress markers, so I'm going to be showing you on camera each color right before I use it, and I'm going to just let some music play so you can enjoy the coloring, and I'll catch up with you when I'm done.
Thank you.
was done coloring, I started to create the card base. Now, this colored image that I've created is actually quite large, and I didn't have quite the right spacing, and so I ended up making a 5x7 card. I don't think I've ever made a 5x7 card on a video before, so it was kind of different for me, kind of a really larger format. But I also wanted to use this Falling Snow stencil from Simon Says Stamp on the card base, and since the stencil is only 6 inches wide, I ended up sponging on that white ink. This is unicorn ink from Hero Arts. I sponged that on completely on one side, and then I just kind of slid the stencil over so I could continue that falling snow pattern on the other side. I'm going to be using this stamp set from Simon Says Stamp. This is the Merry Christmas stamp set, and I'm prepping my red cardstock with my Inka Dinka Doo embossing magic powder bag, and then stamping the sentiment in Versamark ink. And I'm using Hero Arts white embossing powder. It's a nice white embossing powder that always melts really nice for me when I heat it with my heat tool. So if you guys are looking for a white embossing powder, I recommend that one. To finish the sentiment, I'm using the Merry Christmas die from Simon Says Stamp. And I use my metal adapter plate and Nina Solar white cardstock. And I use that metal adapter plate because it helps get a really crisp, clean cut when you're using really intricate dies like this. I adhered it to the red cardstock using little tiny dabs of Tombow Mono Multi Glue. Used my tweezers just to help position that just right so that I could press that down onto the red cardstock. And then I cut out the red cardstock so I could get the sizing right for the rest of the card. And then pulled in some pattern paper from Doodlebug. I'm using the gray and white kind of diagonal striped pattern paper. Cut it into a little strip, put a line of glue on the back, and then adhering that straight to the front of the card. I used my Tombow Stamp Runner to adhere that red piece onto the card also. I thought about putting on foam, but I knew I was gonna be putting that watercolor piece on top, and I didn't want it to get too tall. So I trimmed down the watercolor piece even more so it was more narrow, and then rounded the corners with a 1/4 inch rounder, added some foam on the back, and then adhered that down onto the card. And now I'm going to be taking a snowflake die from Simon Says Stamp. This is the Kate snowflake die. And I cut that out using some Basil Vellum cardstock, punched out the little holes and interior pieces with my Tim Holtz craft pick. And then I'm going to be adhering it to the card using a little tiny bit of glue right in the center of the snowflake. I'm going to be covering up that center of the snowflake with a rhinestone, so I'm not too concerned about the adhesive showing through the vellum. So I'm using a little jewel rhinestone from Doodlebug from their Christmas assortment, and I just put a little red rhinestone right in the center of that snowflake. Now at this point I realized I wanted to fill in that gap right above Christmas, and I thought a white heart would be adorable. So I have all these white hearts that I've pre-cut using the Simon Says Stamp mini heart die set, and I picked out one of the smaller hearts, kind of placed it on there to make sure it was the right size, and then cut a foam square so that it was really, really tiny and would fit on the back of this heart. So I adhered it down to the card and then took some Ranger enamel accents in white and put that right on top of the heart. It made it really glossy and kind of puffy. I took a white gel pen, dotted the I on Christmas, added some dashed lines on the red piece of cardstock, and then that pretty much finishes the card. The only other thing I added was I rounded the corners on the very bottom with a 1/2 inch corner rounder, and then the card was complete. I hope you guys enjoyed today's card. I have a special card video tomorrow that's not part of the card series, and then I'll be back on Friday for day 5. I have 3 more videos for you guys to check out, and they are the last 3 years of the holiday card series. So that first video is from 2012, from day 4, and then the video in the center is from 2011, and the very last video on the right is from 2010. So I hope you guys will check those videos out. If you love this card video and you want to see more of these holiday cards and not miss any of the holiday card series for this year, go ahead and hit that subscribe button in the top corner of your screen. You can always visit me at my blog at kwernerdesign.com, and you can catch me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and Pinterest. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will catch you guys next time.